Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2 on the RPG Check. Continuing. I believe we only have 4 clusters to go, not including the one with the Reaper IFF that I'm gonna hit last, obviously. There's nothing else. This is really strange. Titan Nebula, I believe. The only system is the Haskins system, and there's only one planet, which is the Capac system. See? Done. So, we're gonna head to the Pylos Nebula to save the crashing ship. It's been so long, you would imagine it would have crashed by now? Let's see what we got here. Ah, the MSV Broken Arrow. Okay, and there's other stuff going on here. There's a fuel depot. Couple probes. Mass relay. Apparently just 2 planets. And the MSV Broken Arrow. Isal. Isal is a standard hydrogen helium gas giant. Though gas giants are known for their powerful magnetic fields, Isal's field is stronger than current models predict. Within the frost line of its solar system, where gas giants do not usually form, Isal is believed to have once been extrasolar. Moderate resources. Let's see if we find any element zero, because it's all I'm looking for. I have plenty of everything else. As you can see. And we really don't have too many more upgrades that I can see. But I want to see if I can break 100,000 with the Ezo. We're not going to be doing it on this planet, however. Let's check this planet. Jonas. Jonas, a methane ammonia ice giant, is being developed as a fuel depot serving the Pylos cluster. Eldfell Ashland Energy has established a base on one of its moons to crack water ice into hydrogen and oxygen and skim helium-3 from its atmosphere. Jonas is also believed to be an extrasolar planet captured by its star. Seems to happen a lot with gas giants. From orbit, Normandy's sensors can pick out a hand-painted sign some waggish employee has left outside the complex. Last chance fuel for 100 light years. What complex? Oh, a base. Oh, on one of the moons. That's funny. Last chance fuel for 100 light years. Element zero for me? No. No, no, no. Then. Okay. Let's check out the MSV Broken Arrow. Anomaly detected. Scans detect a rapidly decaying derelict ship in orbit over planet Jonas. Registration matches the MSV Broken Arrow. Ship's manifest notes volatile munitions cargo on board. If left undisturbed, the ship's trajectory will lead to impact with Jonas. High probability that the crash site will be Fargone, Jonas's largest human colony. Geth signatures detected aboard the MSV Broken Arrow. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? This looks like it might be another timed mission. Saving here. Just in case. I mean, it'll probably auto. Maybe we can start the mission over. I don't know. I just like to do that. Okay, so we're having Geth. Let's take Tali and... Kasumi. Yeah, Tali and Kasumi again. They have some pretty good abilities against mechs. Still, I have to mess with this energy drain. I have to come across, you know, a bunch of things with shields. And the others too don't have any points, so.
Warning. Collision with the planet's surface is imminent. I am transmitting.
Oh, did he shoot that human?
Oh, God. Until impact.
We're in the house. Oh, see. Oh, yeah, we're counting down. I'm moving the ship to yellow alert. While we have seen no signs of trouble, I'm not so sure we won't run into Geth this far out. We have to be prepared for anything. I've been told it's a terrible idea to go this far out toward Geth territory, but these colonies need to defend themselves. Sometimes I think the only thing keeping the crew from shriveling up in fear is the 100 crates of military-grade weaponry on board. A little shore leave when we get to the Nariph system will do us all some good. We have a lot of deliveries to make, and it's not going to get any friendlier out here. I hope the timer is paused while I'm reading this stuff. Red alert. Moving the ship to red alert. The Geth are attacking. We're ill-equipped for an attack of this magnitude, but we'll do everything we can to survive this. These colonies need these weapons, and this attack is further proof of how dire the situation is out here. Signing off. This will be the last entry in this log. Given the severity of the Geth attack, I have ordered all hands to evacuate and head toward the colony. Should the Geth succeed in capturing the ship, they also gain control of the 100 crates of weapons in the cargo hold. Therefore, I am using my authorization codes to scuttle the ship, hopefully destroying the Geth that remain aboard. I intend to stay aboard to make sure the ship dies gracefully. Hopefully we can save him. My plan, Captain Thomas Johnner, MSV Broken Arrow. My plan is to disable the ship's engines, thus causing our orbit to decay. This will bring the MSV Broken Arrow down to the surface, where the self-destruct timer will destroy the ship. I must be careful. If I fail, there's no telling where the ship will end up. Okay, we did pause. Was it here?
Incoming.
Yep. Doesn't it only work on shields?
How'd you like that?
How do you like that? How do you like them apples? 100 credits. Let's get everything else first. 1200 iridium. Ship status. Navigation offline. Life support systems damaged. Hull breach detected. Local atmosphere venting to space. Failing. Engine status disabled. To restore power, re-engage the power couplings. Warning. Atmospheric entry detected. Impact with planetary surface imminent. Re-engage the power couplings. Nothing attacking?
Down you go. Down you go. Ah.
That's the idea anyway. Trying to drain his shield. That's not working. Got a big guy up there. Power coupling one. She's recharging.
Down you go.
I take your shields for my own. I kind of like that. She's still recharging? What's going on? Ah.
I'll take care of it.
Ow. Well, I gotta make my way over to the other... Oh, iridium, cool. Getting damaged here. Something's going on with Kasumi. She's screwed up. Ooh. Don't get up. How do I get down? How'd you get up? Oh, through here. Oh, she got herself loose. Oh, where do I go now? Oh, it was interrupted. Was I interrupted with the other one too? Yeah, I was interrupted. Now where? Tell me I have to go this way. Oh, do I go back up here? Oh, engine control. Let's hope I can do this without being interrupted. Take care of him, guys. I have faith in you. We did it! We started the engines.
We've done it.
We've done it. Yay! Stabilize MSV Broken Arrow. Remaining Geth have disengaged. The colony is safe. What about this captain? Well, he's dead. Maybe that was his body. 125 experience, as always. 7,500 credits. 2,000 iridium. Bloop. Okay.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Mm-hmm. Totally shocking. Never saw it coming. To the Normandy, our thanks from Raphael Cologne. Wonder if he smells nice. Governor of Fargone Colony, Jonas. Normandy crew, we retrieved your identity from the docking data aboard the MSV Broken Arrow. We're led to believe that your crew is responsible for saving our colony from a catastrophic event. Yes, you are indeed correct. Not only did you defeat the Geth and prevent the ship from crashing into the planet in a trajectory that would have destroyed our colony, but you also saved nearly 100 munitions crates that would have been lost in the ship's scuttling. Thanks to you, we are safe and can continue the Broken Arrow's work in arming the colonies on the fringe of Geth space. On behalf of the residents of Forgone Colony, you have our eternal gratitude. Cool. I'm curious about something. He was talking about crates. Oh, we already did that. This I'm supposed to save for, like, last or something. Sorry, guys. I just want to check something. Aria left something for us. And I gotta find out where... I don't know where this package was. I mean, maybe it's not in our assignments. Lost operative. Yeah, I never found poor Daniel. Yeah, interesting. I don't know. I'm gonna make a note for... look into that. We have the rest of this system to check out. It's only 18 minutes in, approximately. Or this cluster, rather. Oh, wow, we have three more. We don't need fuel, right? No, we're good. Let's check out Chrysorai. Actually, let's check out Dorada. I got a lot of planets here. Look at this sun. Waiting for us to burn up. Okay, planet number one. Ciano. Named for an ancient Asari philosopher known for being a contrarian, orbits Dorada at a retrograde. It is believed to be an object that fell into the system millions of years ago from parts unknown. The outermost of Dorada's two inner asteroid belts is thought to have been a small planetoid that was broken up by Ciano's passage into the system. Ciano is formed of low-density rock and is tidally locked to Dorada. The same hemisphere always faces the star. There is evidence that a complex of artificial structures once existed in the north of the sunward-facing hemisphere, but they have been badly degraded by millennia of heat and radiation. Several bunkers of radioactive waste, apparently byproducts of primitive fission plants, have been discovered on the far side. Okay. And it's rich in resources. So, we got element zero. Nice. We might break 100k.
Probe away.
Long ride. Long road to 100k. Lately we've been finding a lot more Ezos. It's just...
Probe away.
That's just where I've been looking.
Away.
98. Oh, got some more here. Nice.
Probe launched.
Almost. We're gonna get it. Finding anymore now. Uh-oh. Wow, really? You gonna stall me out here, game? I've got 99,596. I mean, we'll probably find another planet. There's three more systems here. Well, two more. Not including this one. Yeah, look at that! Tease. Second planet from the sun. Thanusi. Thanusi is a small, barren rock, though there is evidence that it once had an atmosphere of carbon dioxide. Only trace amounts of krypton and xenon remain. Like Ciano, it is tidally locked to Dorada. Rich resources. Any Ezo on this planet? Apparently not. I mean, unlike the others, after I reach 100k, I'll just keep getting Ezo, because I've got a mind for something. I don't know. I'm almost done with all these planets, anyway. It's got a couple more clusters after this. Yeah, there's nothing here. Not for me, anyway. Third rock from the sun?
I have detected an anomaly.
Oh, we got an anomaly. On Canalus. Canalus is smaller than Earth, but has unusually high density. The high level of tectonic activity indicates that the density is caused by an abundance of radioactive materials in the core. These, combined with the planet's unusually high rate of spin, raise the planet's internal temperature and cause volcanism. While several companies performed mineral assays in the late 2170s, the world's geological instability precluded development. Not gonna land here this episode. Let's check it out. Something detected.
Probe launched. I have found something.
You sure have. Sensors detecting anomalous weather patterns on the planet's surface. Geth activity detected. Recommend extreme caution. Alright. We'll land there next episode. We'll check out the rest of this system first. So anyone who's sick of looking at planets can tune out now, I guess. Not finding any Ezo here. Okay. Check out the other few here. Number four. Only halfway done. Zeth. Zeth is a common hydrogen helium gas giant. An abundance of sulfur in the upper atmosphere gives it distinct yellow stripes. Moderate. Got anything here? All right. Going to the next. Sinius. A standard hydrogen helium gas giant, Sinius has more than 80 moons. Very small, short descriptions. Poor results. Give me a little ESO, enough to... I really only want... 406 ESO. I'm gonna hit that 100,000. I feel so accomplished. But no. Nope. Alright. Got at least one more planet. VRSA. How do we say it? With an orbital planet nearly 2 millennia long, the cold and distant VRSA was actually missed in the initial Asari survey of the system. Only a follow-up mineral assay sent to Canalis by a Volus mining concern noticed its subtle movement across the stars. VRSA is a methane ammonia ice giant circled by a retinue of deep frozen moons. Its remoteness makes it a popular drive discharge point for pirates working the Pylos Nebula cluster. In the last 2 years, several dozen ships have disappeared while passing through the Dorada system. As Pylos is currently unclaimed by any sovereign power, Council naval patrols are few and far between. Thus far, none of the pirates responsible have been apprehended. What a shame. Poor results. Which is also a shame. And some stuff, but not any element zero in here. Damn, it's stuck at just 400k, that's insane. I feel incomplete. Oh, we're at 100%, okay. What'd I hit? Yeah, sometimes we get that. Hear that? Right there. It's like there's something there. Alright, so stay tuned for next episode when we go on to Canalis to disable the Geth device. So until then, endure. And enduring, grow strong.